Alright, so for this one, we're going to do the crank sensor. So, when you get the wiring harness, this is all going to be one piece right here. It's not going to have this plug here. You're going to want to cut this wire around 4 to 5 inches from the edge here. So just cut it. And then we're going to add this Molex connector in here. The female side will always be on the wiring harness. So this will demonstrate the wires that are inside of here. And if you use the Molex stuff, you basically get a connector. This is a male connector. And you want to use a male tool with an M on it. So you open it up, insert the connector in. We're going to use 20 gauge. This stuff's pretty thin. Push this tool down right here.
Maybe power wires, like,
insert the wire inside.
They're all melted.
Until it hits the stopping plate right here. You feel that? Hook it up.
That defense feels good.
Pull the connector out, make sure it's all good, that the wires haven't come off of the side. And then you'll want to insert the connector. So this is the male connector. And this little dimple part goes to the dimpled part of the connector. Simply insert them until they click. And then pull on it. Good. For a female side, you do the same thing. You want to strip just a little nub off the edge. Use a female connector, which is square. And then use a female pliers. You've got an F on it. Simply stick it in just like the other pin. Push down the back of the plate. Crimp it. Pull it out. Stick it in your female connector, just like this. Same deal.
Yep.
Clicks and pull it. Well, it's how you do Molex. And for this crank sensor, the order is you have to put the yellow one in first, which is in a 3. Then the blue goes in the middle. And the green is a 1. So green is 1, blue is 2, and 3 is yellow. And you can actually see the little numbers on both the male and female connectors. So you do what I did here, these guys. And then you're also going to want to find the other Molex connector. There's 2 Molex connectors you have to do for this wiring harness.
Figure out what we
this
have.
One will have the ignition switch, which we messed on here, and the MIL wires. And you basically cut those, put the MIL into the one connector, and put the ignition switch, the pink one, into the 2 connector. It's a 3-prong female socket. So after you do that, you'll want to do the ground. And normally there's just a little black stubby wire coming out of the wiring harness fairly close to the fuse box over here. So you basically want to get that little stubby wire, strip it, and I'll just use a demonstration, this gray wire instead of this black wire. So to strip the wire, use the strippers. Then you can either use 2 methods to secure this. You can use a butt connector, or you can solder it.
Hey Tony, did you ever get a torch
before? You got this one.
There's a butt connector right here. It has 2 ends to it, 2 ends. Stick the wire inside. And you want to use the regular jumpers for this, with the little oval side. Stick the wire inside. Rip it. Then you'll want to do the same to the other side. Basically crimp them together. And and then make sure you put a heat shrink on before you do this, and melt the heat shrink after. And then you're gonna run a wire around 20 inches long to this little group of grounds over here. And over here there was just this little guy sticking out from that black wire over here, so you're basically adding a bunch of length to it. And you wanna make sure it's the same length of these two little black ground connectors over here. So after you get your 20 inch or so long wire, take it over here, add another butt connector to it, and just make sure it's the same length of these, so they can all be grounded in the same spot in the chassis. That's how you do the main DCM wire harness.